I would like to take this pleasure and opportunity to invite you all to this special lecture by Professor Gautam Radhakrishna Desiraju here at SIMP today. So this is a lecture that has been organized as a part of outreach activity of the International Union of Crystallography. Now before the lecture starts and before I invite Professor Mallareddy to kindly introduce the speaker, there is one request to you all. Please put your mobile phones in silent mode or please switch it off. With this note, may I now request Professor Chilla Mallareddy from IIACR Kolkata to come on stage and welcome our guest. Malla, please.
Thank you, Dr. Soumyajit Roy, for introducing me. Before introducing Professor Gautam Desiraju, I would like to request Professor Gautam Desiraju to come to the dais, please. May I now request Satakshi and Jessica to please come onto the dais and present a bouquet to Professor Desiraju. Now I would like to introduce briefly about Professor Gautam Desiraju. So I'm going to keep it very short and Professor Desiraju is now at Indian Institute of Science Education, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, in the Solid State and Structural Chemistry Unit. And he was born in 1952 in Madras, and he was in the University of Hyderabad for 30 years, and he is the member of advisory board of Angio-1-Techeme and Journal of American Chemical Society. So these are the very prestigious journals in chemical sciences, and he was the first chair of Godan Research Conference, which was organized in United States, and he is the recipient of honorary doctoral degrees, degree of the University of Nicole di Corbada, so from Argentina, and so from the scientific part, so he has introduced the concept of supramolecular synthons that has helped the field of crystal engineering to grow and then make a lot of impact on the real applications in medicines and many various other fields. And he was, due to his contributions, the weak hydrogen bonding CHO interaction has gained acceptance among scientists, and that has a lot of implications in structural, small molecule structural chemistry and biology, and made many functional materials in material science. And he has won many international awards in chemistry and biology. So he won the Alexander von Humboldt Forschungspreis Twas Awards, and he is the immediate past president of International Union of Crystallography, and he is the chairman of the IUCR 2017 Congress, which is going to be held in Hyderabad next year during 21st to 28th August. As part of the outreach activity for this International Union of Crystallography Congress, which will be held in next year, so we are doing the educational, Professor Desiraju has been actively promoting outreach programs on crystallography to young students to bring the benefits to the younger generations and take it forward and help the community. So now, without taking much time, I would like to introduce Professor Gautam Desiraju to give his lecture. Thank you very much.
And it is one of the important
spin-off from crystal engineering, and for people who are working and studying in crystal engineering, this is quite a nice development. And India is particularly strong in this subject, and I'm just putting a paper here which was written 4 or 5 years ago, polymorph salts and home crystals. So you see the authors, all the authors are here, and the authors of this paper come only from 2 countries, from India and from the US. So we had a meeting in Delhi where some of these people from the US came. Dr. Mallareddy in the audience is one of the authors on this paper. So many others are there. So it's very unusual and unique to have so many authors on a paper, firstly, to start with, in chemistry. It's very rare. And then all of them coming only from 2 countries. Now I'm telling you something. I told all the fellows that are rushing to America. I'm saying it's no use. Why those Americans came here and why they put their names on this paper? They are not going to put all these Indian names just for fun. They are supposed to be much better, no? That's why we are all going there. They are coming here and putting their names on a paper which has got so many Indians. That means something is going on in this country in this subject. Otherwise they won't come. They won't even agree to writing a paper like this with only Indian names and American names. So that means this pharmaceutical thing is something where there is much work going on in India. That's all I want you to know. It is a developing field of the future through crystal engineering. So very recently, this is something we did in our own lab. These are 2 very common medicines which are sold all over the counter, norfloxacin and sulfathiazine. You can buy it in any corner chemist. And these medicines are sold in what is called a combination. And for many kinds of what are called mixed infections, you need to give both of them. Doctors will tell you that. So we found out that by putting these 2 together like a co-crystal, like what I just told you, putting them together, instead of taking 2 different tablets, usually doctor will give you 2 different tablets and say take both. By combining them together into the same crystal, we found out that the properties can change in a very, very nice way. What do I mean? See, this actually was put in the Hindu a couple of weeks back. And it says IISc produces a salt to combat bacterial infection. The problem here is this norfloxacin, which is the antibacterial, is not very soluble in water. Sulfathiazole is soluble. So when it's not soluble, it will not get absorbed. The doctors know this. And what they do is they go on prescribing increased dosages of norfloxacin. Bigger and bigger tablets. If that doesn't help beyond a point, some will dissolve, but most of it then gets stuck. And it literally gets stuck physically in the blood vessels. And then it causes some other problems like stroke and all that. So you are getting other diseases which are much worse than the disease that you are supposed to cure originally. Be very mistaken you. So this is a problem. Now we found that if you take the sulfathiazole and norfloxacin together, well, that is the 2 molecules themselves. This is the norfloxacin, this is the sulfathiazole. You don't worry too much about this thing. And that's how it looks inside the co-crystal. This is the sulfathiazole, and this is the norfloxacin, and you can see these hydrogen bonds. But these are now strong hydrogen bonds. They are not this weak type that I spoke about. The strong ones. So it's all the co-crystal. The molecules are all together in the same crystal. They are not separate. The 2 are not separate anymore. Now something very interesting happens. This combination is soluble together. The insoluble norfloxacin becomes soluble. And more important, this norfloxacin, it cannot go through the membrane. Why I say membrane? Because most of the medicines you take, they are absorbed in the small intestine. Okay, so it has to go through the what is called the membrane of the small intestine to actually go into the tissue. That is not aqueous. So the molecule of norfloxacin cannot go through, sulfathiazole goes through. What is happening here is seen very nicely in this picture. If you take the two medicines separately, only sulfathiazole goes through but norfloxacin stays out. So not only it's not soluble, it is not going through the membrane also. If you put them in the co-crystal, both go through. So it is like sulfathiazole is actually catching norfloxacin by the hand and taking it through. It's as simple as that. So that's enough of science. And in the few remaining minutes, I'd like to come back to this conference and what it really means to all of us. See, this is a stamp that was produced 2 years ago in connection with what is called the International Year of Crystallography. The molecule is an interesting one, it's called curcumin, which is the essential constituent of turmeric, haldi, which is there in all our cooking. And where we won a big patent case, Government of India won a patent case on curcumin a few years ago. But I am more interested in that stuff below. That is the Kohinoor diamond, which we have actually now put on one of our stamps. And I am sure all of you know that it came from this country. And yeah, that's what we are asking for. And that's where it used to sit, in the Diwani Khas, the Red Fort in Delhi, where it was part of the peacock throne of this man,